Eric Levine here with a sweet Commander 2017 card reveal. So this time around, the decks are tribal themed, and appropriately, today is Cat Day to sync up with one of the cat-themed tribal decks that is going to exist in the new Commander. And so my preview card is a cat. It's Alms Collector. It's 3 and a white for a 3/4 cat cleric with flash, and it says if an opponent would draw 2 or more cards, instead you and that player each draw a card. So at first look, this seems like a lot of the white hate cards that get planted in Commander and Conspiracy, cards like Containment Priest and Sanctum Prelate, that are kind of plants for Eternal formats, you know, something to hose a particular strategy. But I honestly don't think that's the case with this card. I think 4 is a lot for Legacy or Vintage for an effect like this. I think cards like Spirit of the Labyrinth or Notion Thief are going to do the job a lot better in those formats. I think Alms Collector is going to be a more multiplayer-focused card, and we'll talk more about why that is mechanically a little later, but just cost-wise. I mean, I'm not a Legacy expert. I play a little Storm, but I'm not a whiz, so I could easily be proven wrong on that part. But I do think this card is more multiplayer-focused. It's interesting that there's a cat that's more of a hate card like this being printed, because a lot of the cats we've seen printed in recent sets, cards like Adorned Pouncer, Pride Sovereign, and Regal Caracal, are more about beating down, so it's kind of interesting and refreshing to see something like this that will exist to back those cards up and fight against unfair strategies that might come up against our cat tribal deck. So if your opponents are casting cards like Blue Sun Zenith, Opportunity, and Harmonize, obviously this cat is going to make them learn to share. Responding to a card like Enter the Infinite is really going to make them sad, because they play their 11-mana spell, they're ready to draw their deck, and instead, this cat comes in and is like, hang on, why don't you draw one card, put one card back, sure, you get no maximum hand size for the rest of the game, but now I get a 3/4 cat, and I get a card too, all for 4 mana. Isn't that sweet? We learned about sharing. It's also effective against some decks, and I say some, that want to cast Wheel of Fortune effects, because of course, everybody would be drawing more than one card most of the time with an effect like Windfall or Wheel of Fate or Magus of the Wheel or any number of other cards with Wheel in the name. But instead, Alms Collector says, how about you all draw one card and I'll draw a bunch. Does that sound good? Yeah, it sounds pretty good to me. There are decks like Nekusar that are going to want you to draw those cards because, well, drawing those cards is going to kill you because of cards like Spiteful Visions and Nekusar itself, Underworld Dreams, etc., etc. But in many cases, wheel effects aren't being cast to destroy your life, and so when that's not the case, Alms Collector looks very good. You can actually save lives with this card as well. I think it's important to consider the political ramifications of cards in multiplayer Commander, because unless you're playing in a very ruthless combo-focused environment, politics are real. And even sometimes in those ruthless combo-focused environments, politics are real, carrying over from game to game. But you can save somebody from a lethal stroke of genius that's being cast on them by playing this card. You can't save yourself, you can only save an opponent. So if you're playing some kind of weird, crazy Emperor team format, it's not going to be helpful, but Emperor Commander just sounds terrifying. If you know something about Emperor Commander and how to make it sweet, please leave a comment. But if you want to save an opponent from a lethal stroke of genius or Blue Sun Zenith, by all means, play Alms Collector, make a friend for life, share a card draw with them, have a cup of tea, and enjoy your new nemesis in whoever was casting that big X draw spell. There is another angle on this that's less political and more about leaning into this card the way people have done with Leovold. Now, I'm not going to say that that's going to be particularly effective because it's harder to build around cards that aren't your commander, but playing this and then casting your own Wheel of Fortune or Windfall seems very, well, destructive to other people's strategies, right? Because again, they replace their entire hand with a card, you replace your hand with a bunch more. So while I don't expect to see a ton of that, I think that decks that have white cards and are interested in wheel effects, whatever that intersection may be, are going to be interested in this card. I think we're going to see this card more often in decks that want to force fair play on their opponents. Decks featuring commanders like Grand Arbiter, Augustine the Fourth, or Gaddock Teague, you know, decks that want you to play by their rules and then go ahead and find ways to break their own rules later. It'll also show up in non-blue control style decks, you know, probably decks featuring commanders like Anaphens of the Foremost or a pairing of, say, Ikra Shiddiqui and Timna, maybe even just a general blue control deck that wants a quick answer to opposing big draw effects. It's worth noting that you can search up this card with Mystical Teachings, because it does have Flash. So if you love Mystical Teachings as much as I do, you'll probably enjoy searching up Alms Collector and denying other people their big draws. I'm sure we'll also see it in mono-white decks, of course. You know, decks that would also play cards like Spirit of the Labyrinth. It's hard for me to say how this will fit into the Cat Tribal archetype, because although I was talking about other cats later, I'm recording this video in the past, so I haven't seen the other cat reveals that are coming out today. I just know about Alms Collector, so it's hard for me to say how this fits into a Cat Tribal archetype. When you're drawing one card at a time, as I expect you will be with a creature-based archetype like this, cards like this do look better and better, although effects like Collective Unconscious are going to contribute to getting you back into the game, as opposed to Alms Collector, which is more of a reactive, preventative measure. But I think some of both of those cards will be important to have in a cat tribal deck. I mean, who knows? Maybe Wizards is printing like Windfall Cat, and I'm all wrong about this, but I doubt it. It's also worth noting that Alms Collector has weird consequences when it's paired with an opponent's Consecrated Sphinx. It puts you and your opponent into this weird card draw Thunderdome, which sounds really cool until you realize your opponent has total control over who leaves and who dies. Well, sort of. So let's say you have Alms Collector in play, and you draw a card for your turn, and your opponent has Consecrated Sphinx. And they say, all right, Sphinx trigger, I'll draw two. Well, Alms Collector says, hang on, let's do some sharing. You'll draw one, I'll draw one, we'll all be happy, right? Well, we just drew a card. So Consecrated Sphinx triggers again. And so now your opponent has a choice. They can keep the game going, this mini game, Trade Secrets style, or they can stop anytime they want. Remember, Trade Secrets is banned in this format. Crazy as that sounds, but it is banned in this format. So I think it's worth thinking about this as kind of a weird, terrifying corner case, because if they have more cards in their library than you, they can just draw you out, because their card says May, and Alms Collector doesn't. Consecrated Sphinx is the May effect here. So if their library is smaller than yours, obviously they're not going to go all the way to the end of the library with this, but if your library is smaller, Alms Collector might just kill you with a little overshare. Even though that kind of corner case is possible, even though this costs 4 mana, I still think this card is good. I think costing 4 mana pushes it from great down to good, because, of course, even though it's hard to play around effects in Commander because there's so many different cards that exist, I think 4 mana is kind of a signal, and if you're playing white, and this came out recently, your opponents are going to be aware of it. Once it fades away from the public consciousness a little bit, the card will get a little better, but I still think it's good, and I am going to be nabbing quite a few copies for my white-based decks. Commander 2017 comes out later this month, August 25th. We're going to have the singles and the decks available for you pre-order right here on channelfireball.com. And if you like this video and you want to see more spotlights on future Commander cards, please make sure to hit the like button down the bottom. And while you're at it, if you haven't already, I'd urge you to subscribe to the Channel Fireball YouTube channel, because there's lots of sweet gameplay videos, strategy videos, and just quick little hits like this one. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.